Well, good morning. Welcome to the Church by the Sea's virtual worship. Rob and I want to welcome you here this morning and invite you to connect with the holy through the inspiration of word, music, contemplation, and consideration. Well, these days, many of us are spending time cleaning our homes. We're decluttering closets and making space as children and adults begin to adjust to a new work and study environment. Well, this morning, I invite you to make space for the holy by decluttering your mind and allowing God's beauty, God's imagination, and God's peace to enter in. So take a deep breath and be present and give yourself a gift this morning, the gift that God gives us, the gift of Sabbath. Let us now turn our attention and thoughts to worship as Benjamin plays our prelude.
Thank you, Benjamin. That was wonderful. Well, good morning once again. Today's service is in the tradition of contemplative worship, and we hope that you find it an inspiration this morning. We worship every Sunday at 10:30, and our meditation is on Tuesday evenings at 7 p.m. We continue to have our yoga on Monday, and our Toddler Tuesday program continues for students and for parents. We also have a knitting ministry on Wednesdays. Knitting has been shown to relax the mind and relieve stress. If you are interested in learning, join us on Wednesdays at 11 for discussion, for knitting, and a little laughter. and we continue to avail ourselves as a community to helping those that are affected by COVID or other issues in their lives. If you have a need for assistance, please let us know. Follow us also on social media and make sure that we have your email to send you pertinent information. We invite you now to join in the singing as we sing Come and Find the Quiet Center.
Come and find the quiet center in the crowded life we lead. Find the room for hope to enter. Find the frame where we are freed. Clear the chaos and the clutter. Clear our eyes that we can see all the things that really matter. Be at peace and simply be. Silence is a friend who claims us, cools the heat and slows the pace. God it is who speaks and names us, knows our being, touches space, making space within our thinking, lifting shades to show the sun, raising courage when we're shrinking, finding scope for faith begun. In the spirit, let us travel, open to each other's pain. Let our loves and fears unravel, celebrate the space we gain. There's a place for deepest dreaming, there's a time for heart to care. In the spirit's lively scheming, there is always room to spare.
Well, thank you, Jake. Now please join with me in this morning's invocation. God of all our days and nights, be with us this day. Let your Spirit wash over us, bringing peace to our hearts and to our minds. Guide our thoughts and help us to hear you, O God, to feel you, to know you. Help us to begin to discover the love that you have for us as we discover love of neighbor and of self. Grant us, O God, an open heart this morning so we may find indeed a quiet center, a place of calm, a place to hear you guiding us forward. And now let us listen to Gabby Allegro sing Rainbow.
Time. blowing, but you're stuck out in the same old storm again. You hold tight to your umbrella, but darling, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. So tie up the bow, take off your coat, and take a look around. Everything's alright now, 'cause the sky is finally open, the rain and wind stop blowing, but you're stuck out in the same old storm again. Let go of your umbrella, 'cause darling, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always
Thank you, Gabby. Let us pray. Gracious God, open our hearts and our minds to your word and to your inspiration. Amen. This reading comes from the Psalms. Happy are those whose way is blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord. Happy are those who keep God's decrees, who seek God with their whole heart and walk in God's ways. You have commanded your precepts to be kept diligently. Oh, that my ways may be steadfast in keeping your statutes. With my whole heart, I seek you. Do not let me stray from your commandments. I treasure your word in my heart, so that I may not sin against you. Blessed are you, O Lord. Teach me your statutes. I will meditate on your precepts and fix my eyes on your ways. I will delight in your ways, and I will not forget your word. So in the reading, may God add a blessing to our hearing and understanding. Amen. Well, in these COVID times, many of us are watching old baseball games on ESPN, or perhaps old movies on Netflix, or we're playing video games. We do all of this as a way to simply shift the focus from news that feels quite overwhelming to something that seems mindless. Well, in the Buddhist tradition, meditation asks us to clear the mind. But in the Christian tradition, meditation asks us to refocus our attention so that we might hear the holy. Meditation is, in fact, a form of prayer. Well, most of our prayers are petitions. We are asking God for the requests of our lives, the things that we need. Help us to, help us with family, relationships, jobs, things that we are, health, other things that we are struggling with. But in meditation, we are to sit quietly so that God can tell us what God desires for our lives, what God wishes from us. Well, we are all created in God's image. We are all unique and all gifted. And I have often asked myself, why? Why has God created us to be so different from one another? What is God's purpose in doing that? Well, I can imagine that the gifts we are given are to be woven together. I believe if I read scripture, that I understand that what God is doing by making us so different is to create a world in which God's kingdom on earth can be found. And that cannot happen with just one set of gifts. It has to happen when we all work together to create that world. But in order to understand what God wants and how God wants to use our gifts versus how humanity wants to use our gifts, we must sit in quiet and listen and be guided. We must take time so that we may hear our divine intention for our lives. Focusing on the holy and letting go of our own concerns and desires is difficult. In these times when we sit quietly, we may fear that feelings of sadness or loneliness may come up. Feelings of loss, concerns over work and children and family, all of those things may come flooding in. And so it may seem impossible to sit quietly right now. But I would propose that now, more than at any other time, at least in my lifetime, we need prayerful, contemplative time. We need time with God if we are to face the challenges that this pandemic has brought to us. Through contemplative prayer and meditation, we move into deeper union and communion with God. And we lay aside all those things that limit us and limit that deep connection. And when we do this, we in fact find serenity, calmness, and peace. We become free of worry and fear. In prayer, we seek answers, while meditation allows us to find them. But often in prayer, we are so consumed with our own thoughts and our own desires that all we can hear is those thoughts. And so what we believe is God's desire for our lives is in fact our own. Meditation helps us to separate. It helps us to discern God's will for our lives versus our own will and wants. In union with God, we begin to accept our circumstances and lives and then discover what might be possible. The job loss that we are experiencing at this moment may lead to a different path that we did not imagine yesterday. The changes that we may have to make, the reconnection with friends and family may be life-changing for them and for us. But it requires that we stop and we listen in the silence. Scripture says to us, "Be still and know that I am God." And though we may be scared, I ask us to look at what Jesus did. Jesus spent time in quiet. He spent time before his ministry in the desert, preparing himself, letting go of his fears, and allowing God to enter in so that he would have the strength and the courage to move forward. Well, if we are to move forward in this pandemic, we are going to need great strength, great courage. We are going to need God close to us, not at a distance, but truly close. It will require us to be disciplined, obedient, and courageous. Thomas Merton, who spent many hours in silence as a theologian and monk, said that to act faithfully, we must do more than register an abstract intention to glorify God. Our actions must be free from automation and routine. Well, for all of us who are faithful and pray, meditation asks us to try a new way. It asks us to consider a way of shaking up that routine and cultivating a new relationship with God. Meditation provides a foundation for the holy to flourish in our lives, and it creates within us a posture of peace and humility so that we might better serve others. This morning, I invite you to focus on two gifts given by God to all of us. One is the phrase in the Psalms, the gift of Scripture, the phrase that said, "With my whole heart I seek you." And the second gift is the gift of breath. Every breath we take is an affirmation of life, a gift. So let us open these gifts. Place your hand over your heart and breathe in, saying to yourself, "With my whole heart, I seek you." And then breathe out all of your worries and fears and anxiety, and be still. And breathe in the holy. And breathe out your own wants and desires. And breathe in, seeking communion with your Creator. Breathe in trust so that you know delight, joy, and peace. And breathe out any resistance. Let us listen as we hear the sounds of beauty, peace, and God.
Without you.
Thank you, Alex. As we join in communion this morning, I invite you to get a piece of bread or something to drink and join with us. And then imagine. Imagine that last Passover, Jesus gathered with his friends. At that last Passover, with Jesus knowing what was to come, what was happening in his mind? Was he able to be present for them? Or was he too concerned with the future? On that last night, whatever was happening, we know that Jesus was still able to teach by washing their feet and helping them to learn about service and humility. He shared his faith, he shared his love, he shared all that he was. And Jesus welcomed all at the table. All that was needed was an open and willing heart, one amenable to God's love and to God's grace. Let us pray.
Almighty God, you made us to know you and to desire to be near to you. Our hearts, in fact, are restless until we come close to you. And to bring us near to you, you sent to us your Son to show us the way back to your side. We thank you for sharing your Son, Jesus the Christ, and for offering examples of faith in the lives of the disciples, the saints, and all the faithful that have come before us. Gracious God, we come to this table to give thanks, to remember, to partake, to be refreshed and renewed. Holy God, refresh our spirits and renew our faith this morning. For you are the one that makes all things new. We pray that you make us new as we eat and drink at your table this morning. May we whom the Spirit lights help bring light to all the world.
Amen. Amen.
Well, we recall anew these words, these acts of Jesus, that on the night that he was betrayed, he shared a meal with his friends, the disciples. And at that meal, Jesus took a loaf of bread. He gave thanks for it, and he blessed it, and then he broke it and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is broken for you."
And in the same way, gathered with his friends, he took the cup, he gave thanks and blessed it and said, "Take and drink, all of you. This is the cup of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, remember me."
Let us pray. Gracious God, send your Spirit and presence upon this bread and this juice. As we eat at your table this morning, may we be renewed in body, in spirit, and in mind. Amen. The body of Christ broken for you.
The cup of salvation. Let us now turn our attention to the breath as we listen to Alexa.
Must I walk?
of heaven. Do you wonder as you watch my face, you go wiser one should have had my place, but I offer all I am for the mercy of your plan. Help me be strong. Help me.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. Jesus was praying in a certain place, and after he had finished, one of his disciples asked him, "Lord, teach us to pray." And Jesus said to them, "When you pray, say, Father, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive everyone indebted to us. And do not bring us to a time of trial." Let us now listen to the song by Leonard Cohen.
I heard there was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, and the major lift. Baffled, can't compose it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I did my best, it wasn't much. I couldn't feel, so I tried to touch. I told the truth, I didn't come to fool you.
Thank you, Derek. That was beautiful. In the scripture this morning, the disciple asked Jesus how to pray. Well, I'm sure the disciple, in being with Jesus, knew how to pray. So what was he really seeking when he asked this question? Well, I imagine that what he wants from Jesus is what Jesus has, a sense of peace, a way in which he would radiate out to the world love, healing, and hope. But to have that sense of peace, to illuminate love and hope, we must practice. We must take time. Great athletes, great musicians practice. You don't get to play the violin like Yo-Yo Ma without first practicing the scale. Well, to develop a meditative or contemplative practice means that we might have to try a few times and fail. We may only be able to sit for a minute, and then two, and then more. Health experts say it takes 60 days to develop a habit, either a good one or a bad one. Well, for all that COVID has taken from us, it has offered us time to develop new spiritual habits, time to commune with God, bringing healing and hope and calmness to our lives and illuminating that to others, even on Zoom. Well, though we are being challenged mentally and physically and spiritually, as people of faith, we have to continue to strengthen that resolve for the journey ahead, just as Jesus did. So practice, so that your faith can grow, your relationship to the Holy can grow, and so that you can continue to radiate that into the world that so desperately needs you. Let's breathe.
Is there a chance? Mine is short and my ears are ringing. Everywhere my skin is singing. Lay down your head and sleep, sleep. I will be pleased your soul to keep. Give yourself over to the deep of day.
Thank you, Annalise. Now please join me in prayer. We give thanks, God, for all the gifts that we have been given, and we remember those who suffer, and we ask your mercy. We remember those who are ill, and we ask for your grace. We remember those forgotten, seniors, the homeless, migrant workers, special needs children and adults, and all those that are struggling with health issues beyond COVID-19, we pray. Grant us compassionate hearts, God, that we can see and hear those around us. We pray for our own concerns and ask to feel you holding us as we listen in silence. Please join me now in the night prayer. Lord, it is night. The night is for stillness. Let us be still in the presence of God. It is night after a long day. What has been done has been done. What has not been done has not been done. Let it be. The night is dark. Let our fears of the darkness of the world and of our own lives rest in you. The night is quiet. Let the quietness of your peace enfold us, all that are dear to us and all who have no peace. The night heralds the dawn. Let us look expectantly to a new day, to new joys, new possibilities. In your name we pray. Amen. Now let us sing together, What a Wonderful World.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you.
And I think to myself, what a
to myself.
Thank you. Indeed, it is a wonderful world. Let us pray.
As you go into the day, remember to breathe, to seek the holy, so that you might know your purpose and feel delight.
Go knowing you are never alone. God is with you, and we are as well. So breathe in, discover your peace and purpose, and then illuminate a path for others. Go now to love and to serve God. Amen. Let us listen now to Benjamin as he plays our postlude.
Thank you.